Now, if you will see here, so let me read the packet tracer activity. This packet tracer activity is 1.2.2.5, connecting device to build the IoT system. Okay, so the background of this activity, again, I'm going to read, and please listen carefully. Now, in this activity, you will build a connected solar base power supply. The sun charges the solar panel, which sends the electricity to the battery for the power storage and distribution purpose. A power meter connected between the reeds and display the amount of power being captured by the solar panel. Because all devices are connected, the IoT capability, they must be registered themselves with the registration server. So it is, this is our registration server. And allowing a user to monitor the entire system from the web browser running here in the PC. Okay, so you can monitor all your system through this PC0. So now let me go to the part one, adding, connecting the necessary devices. So you will start with the LED, a PC, a switch, a server, adding following devices to locate and drag the packet tracer workspace. So light emitting diodes, LEDs, these are the LEDs. LEDs stand for light emitting diodes, are electronic component used to emit the light. LED, LEDs are widely used in the electronic as the form of the user interaction. So this is LED, same like the your lights, okay? So we need to glow these light. We need to turn on the light with our power solar panel system. So we will add the solar panel system, first thing. Then we will add the battery storage and power meter. Okay, so first thing, what we need to do, solar panel device. Okay, so solar panel device, how you can get the solar panel device? Okay, you can see here, these are the end devices. Just click on the end devices. Okay, where is the, sorry, click on the end devices. Okay, if you will click on the end devices, okay, then you will find the solar panel here. Okay, click on the end devices, okay, and power grid. So if you will go to the end devices, see here, industrial and power grid. So this is the power grid. Okay, all of you can see this one, the power grid. So because you need to add the solar panel, you can see this is our solar panel. Go to this one first, again, end devices. Okay, this is your end devices, click here, then go to the power grid. Okay, then go to the power grid. In the power grid, you need to add a solar panel. Okay, so this is a solar panel we added. Okay, here, so solar panel. Then the second thing is power meter. Okay, so is it a power meter? Power meter is again end devices and power grid. Okay, so this is your power meter. Okay, this one, this device, this is your power meter. So just you can wait for a while. Once the activity will finish, you will understand fully. So this is our power meter. Okay, after the power meter, you can add a battery device. Okay, so then you need to add a connected battery. So connected battery here, this is the battery. Okay, because this is the solar panel, you know what it will do. Solar panel will get the power from the sun and will provide to the battery. So battery will get charged from the solar panel. Okay, so how you can make your lights smarter and how you can make your light on with through the power from the solar panel. Okay, we will not make it smart, just we need to turn on the light by using a solar panel. Okay, and this battery will get the power from the solar panel. Okay, this is the first thing. So power meter, what it will do, power meter is basically, it will check how much power is left with the battery, because how much power has been consumed and how much power left. Okay, so now these are the things we need to do. So far it is okay for you, all of you. So do you know how you can get the solar panel, how you can get the power battery, and how you can get the power meter? Okay, so do you know all these things? Yes, please, all of you, it's okay so far.
Please like and subscribe to Heather Tech.
Okay, now Now, using a IoT custom cable, connect the solar panel and the battery to a power meter according to the table below. So first, what we need to do, connect a solar panel and battery to the power meter. Okay, first we will connect this one, the power meter, and from this battery to a power meter. Okay, from the cable, IoT custom cable. Okay, so this is your custom cable. If you will go to the cables here, see the connection here. Okay, see the connection here. Here you have the IoT custom cable. Okay, IoT custom cable. So this is your solar panel. Solar panel D0, power meter D0. Here we will use D0 and power meter. What is the D0? Okay, based on this table, we are connecting. So we connected solar panel to a power meter. Okay, then again, this is a battery. Okay, so port D0 and power meter D1. Okay, same this IoT cable. So D1. So this is D1. Okay, power meter D1, and here. This is power meter D1, and this one, based on the table, we will connect. This is D0, okay, battery D0. So this is the connection. I made a connection based on the given table. You can do it anywhere, but it will not according to the instruction given, okay? So if we will make it D0, D1, these are the digital port, okay? We will discuss later on. This is just a simple activity today we are going to complete. So D0, we have connected the port of the battery with D0 and power meter with D1, okay? Now it is connected. So using the IoT custom cable, connect the LED to the battery according to the table below, okay? Now, so IoT custom cable can be found under the connection, okay? So IoT custom cable, okay, you need to connect LED 1 to D1, okay? D1 to LED, sorry, LED 1, okay? Then, so LED 2 to D2, so this is your LED 2 to D2, and LED 3 with D3, you can see. Now it is glowing, you can see, once we are connecting, it is glowing. It is getting the, you can see now here with D4 we have connected. You can see here now it is getting a power directly from the, from where it is getting a power? Yes, please, can you see here? Can you tell me from where it is getting a power? Yes. It is getting a power from the solar panel. You can see, yeah, this is a solar panel, it's a power meter. Okay, so now the power left. This is the power, it is going to detect the power level of the battery, okay? Now, you can see the packet tracer may name the IoT device differently. While name will not impact the activity, feel free to rename your device for easy identification. So this is our solar panel. I will just simply write solar panel, okay? Solar panel, okay? Solar panel, okay? So this is my solar panel. And this is my power meter. Just let me write it here. Power meter, okay? Power meter. And this is my battery, okay? This is my battery, okay? This is my battery. I will write PATTERY, battery. So this is my battery, okay? So now, for simplicity, packet tracer does not implement the power cable properly. Wiring and powering device involve concepts such as ground polarity and all these things. Leave it all this one, okay? Don't get confused. So using a Ethernet straight through cable, connect the Ethernet port of the solar power battery and power meter to the switch according to the table below. So this is to ensure they can communicate with the server. Ethernet straight through cable and can be found under the connection. If you will see here, so now what you need to do, you need to connect solar panel with your switch, with your internet. Suppose this is your internet, your network, okay? Because this is your server. So all these devices should be registered with your server, okay? So how you can make them register here? First, you need to connect your devices, solar panel, with your network switch, okay? This is your switch, okay? Like same like we have the Cisco switches, okay? So this is a switch. So you need to connect with your switch, okay? So your power meter, you also need to connect with your switch, okay? And you also need to connect your battery with the switch, okay? How you can connect? So solar panel FE03, so this is straight through cable, okay? So you can connect through the straight through cable, okay? So this is your straight through cable, okay? Take it and gigabit 00 with, so what port? FE03 port of the switch, okay? Then this power meter, you can connect with the FE04 port, okay? Based on the table here. Then battery, you can connect the battery with your FE05 port. Now it is clear, you can see. Now it is connected with your network, because I need to see, because here I can monitor my all the devices through this computer, okay? Suppose I'm sitting somewhere else, okay? I'm sitting somewhere else to monitor my solar panel system, okay? This is my panel system I need to monitor. So what is the battery level? How many LEDs are on? What is the power meter? So I need to monitor through this PC0, okay? So in order to monitor, so first I need to connect this solar panel with the switch, power meter with the switch, and battery with the switch, okay? Because then it should be registered with this server, okay? It must be registered with the server. So how it can register with the server? Now go to the part two and we will see. Now the devices are properly cabled. They must be configured. Since the system relies on the IP network, the device must be configured with the correct IP information. Since the server is configured to also act as a DHCP server. So this server, we already configure as a DHCP, okay? So we already configure the DHCP server here in this server, okay? If you want to see, go there and I will just show you here. See, the DHCP is already configured here, okay? You can see the DHCP is already configured here, okay? Now, so the IoT should be configured as a DHCP client in order to learn the IP information automatically, okay? So these, it will get the IP automatically. Solar panel, power meter, and battery should get the IP automatically from this server, okay? Now, click the solar panel navigation, navigate to the config tab and gigabit, this one, and select the DHCP and IP configuration. So we will go by this step and we will go to the, you can see config tab, gigabit 00, if you will see here, DHCP. Just click it here. So it will get the IP from the DHCP server, okay? So this is our server and it is getting, this our solar panel is getting the IP from the DHCP server. This is the first thing here. So this should also get the IP from the server, okay? First, we will go to the power meter, config tab, fast Ethernet, DHCP. So it gets this IP address from the DHCP server. Now, battery also, we need to get the IP from the server here, okay? You can see it will get the IP from the DHCP server, okay, with the battery. Is something wrong with the battery? Okay. Fast Ethernet, DHCP. Yeah, now it is getting the IP, okay? You can see now the battery is getting this IP address, and this IP address, you can see here the IP address, and so your solar panel get this IP address. So you have 1.0.0.3, 1.0.0.4, and 1.0.0.5. So these devices are getting the IP from the server. Okay, this is clear. So what IP addresses were learned by the solar panel, power meter, and the battery? As I told you, so what IP addresses? Yes, please tell me. So the solar panel get this IP. If you will see here, so this is the IP address 1.0.0.3, and what IP here 1.0.0.4, and battery 0.0.5, okay? Now it's clear? Yes, please. Here, this is our DHCP server, okay? You know, I don't need to explain to you how you can configure a DHCP because it's pre-configured. Even you don't need to know how to configure the DHCP because you already finished network fundamental 1 and 2, yes? Assign the IP addresses automatically to the clients. Okay, yeah. So this is the basic purpose of the we will not say the client, we will say it will assign the DHCP server, assign the IP addresses to end devices. Okay, suppose solar panel is our end device. Okay, it is getting the IP from the DHCP server, and power meter is also our end device. It is getting directly IP address from the DHCP server. Okay, now if you will see how we can do it, so the steps are given. First, you need to click tab. Okay, so first what you need to do, first you need to go to the solar panel here. Okay, then go to the config tab, and this the FA00, you can see, just click here DHCP. You can see there is a point, so IP configuration mean DHCP. Just click here DHCP, it will get the IP directly from the DHCP server. Same way for power meter and the battery. Okay, so before the devices can operate properly, they must register to the server, okay, and configure the device with the server IP address to allow them to find the communicate to the allow them to find and communicate to the server. So what we need to do, so because this server, so these devices are not registered, it just get the IP, but we need to register these devices with the server. It means then we will be able to monitor through this PC0. Okay, now this is our server IP address. If you will see, this is our server IP address. So what is the IP address of our server? Go to the desktop. You can see this is our server IP address. I will just copy. Okay, and I will go to the solar panel, config tab, setting remote server, IoT server. Okay, then here go to the how you can register your devices with the server. This is the point. Okay, the first thing is config tab. This is a config tab. Then go to the setting. Okay, this is the setting. Okay, in setting, go to the remote server here. See, just click here remote server. So what is the server IP address? Here, just you can add the server IP address. So this is our server IP address. So this is our server, because we need to make them register. Solar panel, power meter, and battery, we need to register, okay? So this is the IP address. So what is the username? Admin. Username is admin, and password is admin. You can see. So this is the username and the password. Admin and admin. Then click connect. Okay? Just you need to connect. Okay, just click it here, like connect. Now done, it is registered. If it is showing refresh, it means it is connected. Okay, now if you will go and you can see here, I will just show you later on, but here go to the web server 1.1. we are going to the server, and the server is admin, password is admin, and admin. Okay, you can see so far the solar panel is, we access the solar panel through this computer. Okay, only solar panel is registered, you can see. Now we also need to register the power meter, so go to the power here. Okay, then go to the setting, go down, come to the remote server, and what is the IP address of your server? 1.0.0.1. Okay, so this is the IP address of your server, and username is admin, password is admin. Okay, click connect, so it will get registered with your server. Okay, now it is registered. You can see here, if you will come, you can see power meter is also registered. Okay, so we also need to register the battery with our server. Okay, now if you will see here, go to the battery, go to the setting, scroll down, click on remote server. What is the IP address? 1.0.0.1, and username is admin, password is admin. Click on connect. Okay, so once you connected, you can see here from this PC, you can see all three devices are registered with our server. So this is the server IP. So it has been registered with the server. Okay. So now all devices are connected. Notice how the solar panel charges the battery and all these things you can easily monitor. Okay. 53 watt power meter 102. You can monitor through this PC. You can see, and the battery available power is 0.35%. So you don't need to come physically here and monitor. You can monitor your environment, your devices through this PC. Now it is clear, all of you, please.
Yes, Mr.
This is a very simple, very simple activity. Just you need to connect and you need to see, because it is not a smart one. We cannot say it's a smart system. This is just a, these devices are connected with the internet. But we can make it smart by writing a program. So how to write the program? Today I will not teach you because you will get confused. How to write a simple program? Suppose if we will say here, if the battery level is 42%, all the LED should be off. So you can say like that one. If the battery level reaches to 50%, two LEDs you can make it on, other two LEDs you can make it off. So it means that system will be a smart system. Did you get me?
Yes.
So this activity, what we did it, we just connect the device to build the IoT system, okay? And in this activity, what we did it, the sun charged the solar panel, which sent the electricity to the battery for the power storage and distribution. A power meter connected between them read and display the amount of power being captured by the solar panel. Because all devices are connected, they registered themselves with the registration server, and allowing a user to monitor the entire system from the web server running on the PC. As I told you, you can see, allowing to monitor the system through this web server. Okay, you can see here. It's clear, all of you? Any question? Now question, how many devices are displayed in the page? How many devices are displayed on this page? How many devices? Yeah, so what are these three devices? Solar panel, power meter, and battery. So these are the devices. Okay. Can I ask one question? Why are the other devices, the switch, server, and PC, is not listed here? Is this a mistake, or what do you think? This is the answer, because these devices are the network devices. These are the network devices, and the network devices are only present to provide the connectivity and should be appear in the list, and it should not appear in the list. Okay, so it will just provide the connectivity. These are not the IoT devices. You said correct. Okay, so this is the basic activity for today.
Please like and subscribe to Heather Tech.